My name is Sabria Smith, and I am the director of the Rescue 100 program with the Mississippi Department of Child Protection Services. And our program is a faith-based initiative that recruits, trains, and supports foster families through engaging the church all across the state of Mississippi. And today I have the pleasure of sitting down with Shelley Eubanks to talk to her about her foster care journey. So Shelley, just tell me a little bit about how you got started in foster care and when.
It was probably about 7 or 8 years ago, and my mother had gotten ill, and we had closed in our garage and made a huge bedroom space. And we had gotten it ready for her, and unfortunately she got too ill, she was not able to move in. So when we came back from taking care of her, we looked around and we had all this space, and we didn't know what we would do with it, still didn't know. But we came to church here one Sunday at Leakesville United Methodist, and in the centerfold of the bulletin from Methodist Children's Home was a whole article about foster care. So I asked my husband, could I just call and ask? And here about 8 years later and 13 children later, we're still fostering.
Wow. So 8 years and 13 kids.
Yes, ma'am.
Wow. And you work full-time here with the court.
I do.
Correct? But still found the time to bring in kids in your home.
Yes, ma'am.
So tell me about the type of kids that you fostered.
Well, when we first started fostering, our heart was really in looking at older children who possibly would be maybe aging out before long, or they were going to be going to college and wouldn't have anybody to support them through the rest of high school and college. And I think one of the things that weighs heavy on my heart is when you have a child away, maybe at school, and they simply get a stomach ache and they don't have anybody to call home to and say, I'm sick.
Right.
Or maybe you have a girl and she's got her first broken heart and she doesn't have anybody to call home and say, I need you to come get him, he hurt my feelings.
I mean, because that is such an impressionable age too. And you know, if you've watched any of these videos, the other guy that I was talking to, Mike, he's got three teen boys, and that's kind of what he talked about too. He just wanted to provide a home for them forever, for whatever they needed. And it sounds kind of the same thing for you guys.
Yes, and you're hoping by fostering that you get a chance to be a blessing, but it's so strange that in return you get many more blessings than you're actually able to give.
So let me ask you this. If you could go back now and tell yourself 8 years ago, when you were filling out that foster application, making that first telephone call, if you could give yourself some advice, what would it be?
To be prepared for probably what every foster parent worries about is letting go, but that's part of the process. Through reunification, that's just something that you have to prepare yourself for, and that's part of fostering. And of course, because we all have feelings and we're all humans, that's probably the hardest part. The children come to us, and of course they're probably traumatized, or you know, they're abused or neglected, or they wouldn't be in our homes. So I guess part of it would be to be aware of all of the different things that we might could look for. And certainly the training helps, you know, what to look for, and then gives us some help on what to do to help these children.
Gotcha. But we can't train the how to love and how to accept that hurt. How did you prepare yourself for that?
Well, I tried to incorporate our foster child, whomever it may be, at whatever age, just like our biological children, and love them the same way. Of course, you don't show any difference when you're a foster parent, because for that point in time, they're your child, they're part of your family, and you want to love them and give them some attention. And if the truth be told, sometimes you have to give them a little more attention than you give those biological children, because they need it at that time.
Give them that foundation that sometimes they missed out on.
Yes, ma'am.
Wow. Okay, so if you could tell someone who was contemplating picking up the phone and making this first step, if you had some advice for them, what would you say?
Pick up the phone and make the call. It's scary. It's scary the first time you make the call. It's scary the third time the phone rings for a placement, or the fifth time, or the eighth time. It is scary every time, because it's life-changing and life-altering. It's life-altering for that child, but also to the family. The family dynamics change every time. For my children, you know, my daughter, she never knew if she would be the youngest child, the middle child. So the dynamics are always shifting, and it's always scary for everybody involved. But if you don't pick up the phone, make the call, go to an orientation, I promise you're going to be missing out on a lot.
Well, thank you so much for putting aside your own fear and your own discomfort for a while just to give the kids in your care hope. We certainly thank you for that.
It's our pleasure. Thank you.
Well, if you would like some more information on how to be a foster parent and make a difference in the life of a foster child, please check us out on our website or on Facebook, Rescue 100. Thank you.